being indicated that there is a guitar that you've brought with you.
Oh, now this is actually, as the cognoscenti among you will know, a Stratocaster. This is Stratocaster. My Telecaster is in fact up in Birmingham or somewhere with the band's equipment. So today we had to come with this. It's probably quite valuable. This Stratocaster I bought when we first got a record deal, had some money to spend. Now, I mean, Stratocaster I've always loved because it is such a beautiful thing. It is one of the great design classics of the 20th century. I mean, the people try and copy it and people try and adapt it and all that, but that is beautiful. I mean, how did they think of that? I don't know, but it's great. So as soon as I had some money, I thought, well, I would like a Stratocaster as well. And of course, I don't know, I couldn't paint it red and black.
Would you like to? I mean, you can talk about it all you want, but actually, what people want you to do is pick it up.
They do, don't they? my technique is very, very. I mean, you got 5 minutes, I'll tell you everything I know. I tried and tried to copy Mick Green. I didn't get it right. I mean, the guy was great. I couldn't get anywhere near that. But I got my own way of doing it. Now, what can I say? This technique it's very percussive, and it's to do with my chord shape's a bit unusual, right? See, this chord shape, very famous. Everyone knows this one. Right, the way I do it is like that. It's four strings here, and whack your thumb over the top for the sixth string. Now, if you hit a chord, there it goes, right? But if you lift your fingers off the frets, it will stop it. It'll stop the sound, so you get like that. Oh. So you. And it's really, that's all it is. Greeny was an expert at playing like breaks with, right? Now, you can, so you've got your chord, you've got all your fingers on it, like you lift your fingers off, what you've got? You've got a dead sound like that. Like that. You can, what's this sound? It just does that, up and down, like that. If you intermittently press your fingers down onto the fretboard, you'll get sounds, and you can cut them on like this. This hand all the time, just like that. Right? Now, you can also fill in with licks and that, and you just keep that thing going, right, like that, and it will happen. Straight to you, this riff. Now, one day I went round Mick Green's house, and he showed me this riff, right? And it was just so fantastic. I rushed home and wrote a song for it, and the song was called "Going Back Home." And so it's all very appropriate because I recorded this song with Roger Daltrey for our album last year, and he goes like, "This one's in the key of A." Right, so you make a chord of A like that. You see, you're supposed to do it like that. Me, I do it like that. Right, and you can put your little finger up there. There's some more A's up there, and the fifth string, that's A. Right, and you can finger the sixth string with your thumb. Right, and so you get the whole thing, put the whole thing together, and you go. When it comes to the solo, like what we used to do in Dr. Feelgood, right? Lee would play the harmonica solo, and you can slide the whole thing, this thing here, you can slide the whole thing up 12 fret, which is an octave up, and you get it like this. That's more than it.
I have got a question here which does seem relevant, and it is from Graham Smith. The question is, why aren't your fingers cut to ribbons?
That's what I used to say to people. They go, why do you have a red scratch plate? And I go, so the men can't see the blood. But I did. Sometimes it would cut, you know, sharp, and it would, especially if sometimes I would have a guitar with a white scratch plate, and it would splash like you'd see the blood splash. It looked fantastic, right? And of course, when you're full of adrenaline and whatnot. On stage, because you can't feel it, so you just keep playing away, you know, and then gradually, but it's all dead to the world now, you know. Sometimes it bleeds, but not very often.
So, thank you very much so far. Let's all go.